In matrices, there are three elementary row column transformations. Matrices, moon row column elementary transformations allowed in under. They are used to find out, they usually used to find out the solutions of system of linear equations, and also used for finding the inverse of matrices. Matrices the inverse kaana nerthu adu pole thanne system of linear equations solve cheyan vendiyum ee elementary transformations namaku upayogapaduttam. Let us discuss them one by one here. First elementary operation allowed is any row can be interchanged with any other row. Similarly, any column can be interchanged with any other column. Rows can be mutually interchanged, columns can be mutually interchanged. For example, we consider this matrix -2, 3, 1, 4. This is a square matrix, and we interchange the first row and second column like this. 1, 4 becomes first row here. Here it was second row, and second row becomes here the first row of first row becomes second row, and second row becomes first row. Similarly, column transformation also allowed. Two columns mutually interchanged, C1 and C2. We got like this. Next property, next elementary transformation allowed is like this. Any row or any column can be multiplied with a non-zero scalar. Non-zero scalar. See, A is a given matrix 1, 4, minus 2, 3. Suppose I multiply the second row with 2. Suppose we write like this. We multiply second row with 2. Existing second row is multiplied with 2. We get a new second row. New, and writing like this. Equivalent matrix A is equal to 1, 4, minus 4, 6. Minus 4, 6 is given by multiplying this second row with 2. Then we proceed to understand what is the third property or third transformation allowed. Any row can be added with a scalar multiple of any other row. Similarly, any column can be added with a scalar multiple of any other column. See, our matrix 1, 4, minus 4, 6. This second row R2 is added with 4 times of R1. We get like this, second row becomes a new row. You see this extra, this equivalent matrix A is equal to 1, 4, 0, double 22. And similar information we do further till getting a desired result. Suppose existing R2, second row is 0, 22. It is multiplied with 1 by 22. We get a new equivalent matrix like this. 1, 4, 0, 1, right? Then again we go to transform the first row. New first row becomes adding first row, existing first row with negative 4 times of second row. Okay, what we get? This is equal to first row 1 is added with 4 times 0, minus 4 times 0, that means 1 only. Minus 4 times minus 4 times 1 is minus 4, minus 4 is added to 4, we get 0. Second row, as it is, we write here. Really, we got an identity matrix, isn't it? Any square matrix like these methods, using these transformation techniques, any square matrix can be brought to an identity matrix like this.